What's up, everybody? I'm Richard.
And I'm Shawn.
And we are speaking the language of bromance. I missed you so much, my friend, even though we saw each other yesterday.
We did. We saw each other face to face. You know what, Richard? You and I, we traveled together a few times, and we have gone east, we've gone south, we've gone a little north, but we've never gone west. You've gone west. I've not.
You know what? You're absolutely. Well, yeah, a little west, but not that far west.
Yeah, kind of like west and down. But there was an expedition, Richard, a famous expedition. I always thought these were two women just because their names seem like women's names. But it was a commissioned trip to the west. Very famous, the Lewis and Clark expedition, right? Thomas Jefferson.
How is Clark a woman's name to you?
I don't know. I always felt like it was women's names. Like, what's their first name?
I don't know. Were they French?
No, they're American.
Well, I mean, there wasn't really much of an America then.
Mayweather Lewis.
This is pre-Louisiana Purchase.
No, this is post-Louisiana. This is right after Louisiana Purchase.
That's right, because we bought it, and so we're like, hey, we should figure out what we bought.
Yeah, and I think this was kind of post, or this was around one of the wars where we got, like, even further, like the Mexican-American War, I think it kind of finished up. No, that hadn't happened yet. We had people.
We're so great at history.
Yeah, right. We did have I think it was kind of like just like open territories. Like other people claimed it, but we kind of went that
versus
way.
Versus the Klingons.
Yeah.
And then the Romulans showed up.
That's history's a good point, though. Weird. That's kind of very like Christopher Columbus. It's like you go all the way to the end of the coast. Like, we claim this. And the Spanish are like, what? Like, we've been here for a bit. But
the Spanish.
Yeah, Spanish, I think, were all that way out. I mean, there were other people there first, but the Spanish were like the foreign power that kind of claimed it as their own.
Well, I thought Columbus showed up before Spain. Because Columbus was Portugal, right?
I thought he was Spain.
I don't Wow. Public school right here, guys.
Well, it doesn't really matter. I mean, he was Italian, but yeah, I think
who cares? He gave him syphilis blankets.
That's true. But he didn't know. Let's
didn't
see.
He?
Didn't
he take a bunch back of slaves? Columbus was not like a fucking stellar dude.
Well,
that's all.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to go back to history, like, it's all not good. You know, I mean, you go back.
You know, as shitty as history, like, as shitty as like the history. As history is, like, all the terrible shit that happens, why are we so optimistic about the present?
What do you mean?
I mean, like, 100 years from now or 200 years from now, when they're learning about, you know, our history, when kids in school are learning about our history, and then somebody's like, you know what really happened? They were terrible people back in the day.
Maybe.
They put phones up to their face and it gave them all cancer.
Yeah, I think it'll be stuff more like that. Like, if you think of
fucking savages.
Yeah. They didn't have. I think that'll be the thing. It'll be more technology stuff. It'd be like, did you know that they used to eat animals? They didn't eat this protein byproduct that tastes like cotton candy.
Animals.
Yeah, it tastes like animals. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I think the present's a lot better than the past for sure. I mean, when would you want to live? Would you want to live now? Or?
Well, yeah, but didn't they say that like 400 years ago? Like, oh my God, we're so much better than those fucking savages 400 years ago. They enslaved people.
Maybe. I don't know. I feel like there's got to be a time where it went down.
We didn't stop enslaving people up until like what, 140 years ago?
It was the 1860s. So
yeah. 160. Yeah. So 160.
Well, I mean, if you want to get technical, there's still slavery in the world today.
In the world, yes. Yeah. Great. So we haven't even cleared that fucking hurdle yet.
Yeah. Well, the problem is as history goes, like, you know, if some bad stuff happens, that might make a comeback. Like,
shit.
Yeah. Like, all bad things can come back. If you don't learn from history, you're doomed to repeat it. And we don't even know who fucking Columbus sailed for.
Yeah. So we haven't learned shit from history.
Well, I mean, to lighten the mood. So, you know, talking about great people, Thomas Jefferson, I think he had a few kids.
Thomas Jefferson was out. Yeah. I mean, they were slaves, but.
But The Lewis and Clark expedition, they're going to map out all the way to the west, right? They're going to get to the Pacific Ocean. No, the Atlantic.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Pacific Ocean.
Pacific.
And map it out, find it. But there was a secret mission, Richard, that Thomas Jefferson.
A secret mission?
Yeah, secret mission. So you think, what was
it? I swear to God, if the word Klingons comes out of your mouth.
Richard?
I'm sold.
How do you feel about Klingons? No.
Almost
as good, though. So Thomas Jefferson had this huge fascination with, like, not really mythical beasts, but, like, they were just starting to discover, you know, bones, and, like, paleontology was just kind of starting up. And in this time frame, like, you talked about, like, holy shit, why are we so optimistic about the present? Back then, Richard, they didn't think extinction was a real thing. They thought when they found these bones of things, these animals existed somewhere in the world. Like, extinction was not on their radar.
Oh, I gotcha. Oh, my God. How fucking crazy would it be if they, like, found dinosaurs then? Like, found, like, dinosaur bones and, like, what the fuck is this thing? I've never seen this before.
Well, pretty close, because they were starting to discover around, like, New York and stuff like that, because George Washington was really interested in this, too. They were finding mastodon bones.
You know why they were interested? Because they wanted to enslave them and make them into pets. They wanted to ride them. Oh, my God. Can you imagine fucking George Washington riding on a woolly mammoth?
Yeah.
Fuck you, King George. Ah!
Yeah, they show up to fight for the French. Fuck. And the French queen is like, I heard the Americans had elephants. Like, oh, well, we couldn't bring them on a boat. Oh, well, that's very disappointing. I was looking forward to elephants.
Yep.
There's a Game of Thrones.
And then somebody slept with the queen.
Yeah. Yep. And then Washington was like, but haven't I done enough? And she's like, if you want a whore, buy one. If you want a queen, meet me in my chamber.
And George Washington did. And that's why we're all descendants of George Washington. Yep.
And that is how we got Egypt.
Yep.
Yep.
Because the pyramids are
one pyramid.
The same
is for King, no, for the queen. One is for George Washington, and the third is their
love child Giza. And the obelisk is his penis.
Oh, I thought it was their love child Giza.
And that's why there's pyramids all over the world, because we're America and we have to put our stamp on everything. Yep.
They're like, well, we don't want to put the flag here because we really don't want to own the land. We just want to know that we've been here. We fucked.
And see, and George Washington was a Mason. Here we go, conspiracy theory time. George Washington was a Mason, and that's why he helped build the pyramids. So if you go to any pyramid and you, like, go to, like, the very base bottom cornerstone.
There's a penny.
and you lift it up. No, it wouldn't be a penny, it'd be a quarter. But no, not what's there.
Oh, yeah, Lincoln's on the penny.
If you lift it up, it'll say the cornerstone under on the bottom in very small print in little tiny hieroglyphics. It says, made in America.
USA, USA, USA,
USA, USA.
But no, Richard, Thomas Jefferson wanted to send Lewis and Clark west to find mastodons. You're like, oh my God, yes, why not? Go find bones.
Yeah.
Find all these cool things. No, Richard, he wanted to find real life mastodons.
Yeah, he's like, go find mastodons. This will totally get me on the nickel for sure.
Yeah. So it's kind of interesting. Like, they, I kind of poked through it, but Thomas Jefferson, they've coined his, like, office the Sanctum Sanctorum, which is kind of interesting.
That's some fucking, see, now we're getting all conspiracy theory here.
Well, he was just big, like, into architecture, like, different sciences, accounting, and, like, he was, like, big into reading, which during this time, like, it was like, what are you going to do for entertainment? Read? What else are you going to do? Go look for mastodons? Which would suck when you find out that, like, extinction is a real thing. You're like, oh, well.
I know. Like, how fucked up would that be? Be like they're all dead. Like, what do you mean they're all dead?
Let's,
like,
go find more.
Everything's dead. There's gotta, yeah, just, they're out there. Like,
the
I got bones.
Big, right?
There's a bone right here.
No,
see,
that's
this?
That's a good point.
Elephants don't make this.
You know, actually, when you think about, like, think about, put yourself in the shoes at this point in time. Like, they've settled, like, to the Mississippi, kind of. Like, there's, like, spots in between the Mississippi and, like, I don't know what, Ohio, that are still kind of, like, dangerous. But there's spots from Mississippi to the Pacific that are definitely untamed. Like, people don't live there. Or if you do, you may not see somebody for, like, months at a time, probably years at a time.
Probably.
You would claim land, live on it, cultivate it, die on it, and somebody else would claim it 10 years from then.
Exactly.
Because it's like,
and they wouldn't have, when they didn't even know, they'd be like, oh, somebody built a house here.
They wouldn't find it for like probably hundreds of years. Like in, you know, 2012, Greg, whose dad bought it, he goes walking around, he finds like some old wood, has sex with his girlfriend on it. And so,
why are we going
some
there?
Some pioneer ghost is like, this was my land.
This is where I slept. Like, why?
What are they listening to? I did it all for the nookie. No! Goddamn Lip Biscuit.
This is where I kept my books for entertainment.
This is where I read. This is where I taught my children to read. This is where Susie died of dysentery.
I read them storybooks right there.
The future is horrible.
Fucking Nancy.
Oh, why can't we still be in the times where we could just build a house from logs and live there until we died and not see a single face ever? Which actually doesn't seem too
bad. That's not how you make babies.
Wait, what's she doing with her? Oh, God, they're doing it like the French. So
Jesus wouldn't like that at all.
Yeah. Made Jesus cry. Why should
if it was Thomas Jefferson's ghost, he'd be like, wait a minute, you can't do that. You don't own her.
Yeah.
See, because he had babies.
He did. With his he had lots of them too, didn't he?
And that yeah, I heard like 20, maybe more.
Not Gouda.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Was it all I don't know. It's murky yeah, water
you
here,
keep
Sean.
And that,
I don't want to dip my toe in it. It's murky water. I don't want to get bitten.
Okay. I'm just, you know. But yeah, yourself.
I'm just saying that there's I don't know. I'm not doing it.
Yeah, I've never researched. I mean, if he was, I don't know if he was like mean or not, but I mean, obviously he owned people.
I have no idea.
Which is horrible.
But we're not talking about this. We're keeping it lighthearted because two guys are gonna go try and find mammoths.
Yeah. So that's what they did. Lewis and Clark went to find mammoths. So Jefferson, I guess, like I said, he carried out a lot of weird scientific experiments at his home. But mastodons were just like super, like he just had a big super interest in them because they'd start finding these bones. And he thought that they were out west. Like he thought like these things must be living out there.
Okay.
And his passion, I guess they said, like, he was so enthralled with this that the floor of the White House, he had mastodon bones laid out and kind of like had them like the Halloween candy, where he's like, oh, here's one bone. Oh, here's one bone. Oh my God, this looks like a trunk. Oh my God. Wow. He's probably like sitting on it too, like sideways, like, yeah, take that, Queen Elizabeth.
He's like inviting people in and be like, and check out this bone.
Yeah. What's his wife's name?
I don't know. Weren't they all named Martha then?
Probably Martha Jefferson.
Martha Washington.
Martha! Maybe that's how him and...
Our wives have the same name.
Why did you say that name? So why did Jefferson believe mastodons roamed west? So the story of this, his obsession with this, was from a book written by Stanley Heaton called The Big Bone Lick. It's kind of like I said...
Ew.
Yeah, icky. The idea behind this is like paleontology was very much in its early, like its infancy. Like they started to find some of these bones. I don't know when the first T-Rex was discovered. I think it was like the late 1800s. But
that sounds right.
But like I said, like he was just really, really interested in this. And the other reason they said is like patriotism, I guess, was a big reason for this too, because the founding fathers really cared about the fossils they were uncovering, because influencers from Europe were basically saying that the New World species that they were finding were far inferior to the European things that they had. So
what did they find in Europe? Did they find dinosaurs in Europe?
I'm sure
they
found like
fuck your dinosaurs. We got hairy elephants.
Probably. Yeah. Well, I mean, they would have found like different bones. I'm sure it's kind of like, oh, you got deer. Your deer suck dicks. Our deers are amazing. Oh, you have bears. Our bears suck.
Fuck your stupid deers.
And then, like, we take
our bears are goddamn enormous.
Yeah, then we take a grizzly bear over to Europe. It's like, hey, look at this bear. That's a big bear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a big fucking bear.
Guess what?
Where's your bear?
Up north. It's a polar bear.
What can your bear do? Mine can juggle.
Mine rides a bike and then bites your fucking face off. There's
a funny hat. Look at him go.
Do you think that's really...
Now eat the king's face.
But that's a weird thing to think about this time, though. Like I said, like Europeans and Americans, and I know they were kind of like in a rough spot at this point because, you know, they fought a war, and this is pretty close to 1812 where they had another war. Where they came and burned down the White House because they're like, fuck your bears.
They couldn't find a cool name for that war, so they just called it the War of 1812.
Yeah, and it went over a couple of years, didn't it? Went like 2 years.
I don't know. As far as we know, it went throughout the course of 1812. Yeah.
They couldn't call it the Second Revolution. I wonder who names were.
The British Empire. Why didn't they call it like the British Empire Strikes Back?
Oh, yeah. Revenge of the British Empire.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Except they lose in the end, and we put the queen in carbonite.
Fucking rewrite the history books right here.
Oh, yeah. It makes more sense.
The War of 1812, the Empire Strikes Back. Now I'm picturing, like, British soldiers on, like, a fucking AT-AT made out of wood.
Which, actually, in that one, they would be the bad guys.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, in history.
And also, it would make sense because if you watch any of the Star Wars movies, I don't know if this was I don't know if this was intentional, but do you ever notice that, like, everybody in all the officers in the Empire had British accents?
I thought were supposed to have, like, German accents. Like, wasn't that supposed to be the big thing?
I don't know. Well, no, because they had the stormtroopers and everything, which was supposed to hearken to, like, Nazi Germany. But if you notice, all the fucking officers had British accents.
Well, I mean, any go-to in that time frame, too. Like, you think the Bonds, it was always a British person that was the bad guy. Like, the mastermind. Although Bond's British, so that probably makes more sense then.
No. Because in fucking shit, what movie was it? Which Bond movie? The one where he was in Cuba, there was like a witch doctor dude. And I can't think of the guy's name, but he had an awesome fucking laugh. He was like, Mr. Bond.
Call him all. He'd tear out their heart.
Oh, fuck. No, he didn't tear out your heart. But he was like a witch doctor, like voodoo doctor dude.
Yeah. Whenever you think of witch doctor, do you sing the witch doctor song?
No, I don't.
Do you want to
sing? Do you?
I do, yeah.
No. Go for it.
I told the witch doctor I was in love with you. Ba, 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 ba. Boom, and boom, then boom, the witch doctor, she told me what to do.
Boom, 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 boom.
She said, ooh, ee, ooh, ah, ah, ting, ting. Is that a bad song?
Wow, wow, bing, bing.
Like, do you ever worry about that? Like, you sing a song, it's like, that song's, like, not appropriate. You're like, oh, well, I didn't know that.
Do I ever worry about singing a song and it not being appropriate?
Yeah, like, it not being, like, being culturally insensitive and you don't know it.
I don't know. For me personally, I feel like a lot of art, especially older art, and when I say art, I'm talking about like movies, music, stuff like that. I feel like a lot of older stuff should get a pass. And I'm not saying like, oh, it was that time. It was, you know, but it kind of was like.
You mean like, yeah, I just don't know. I think it's one of those like you watch some cartoons like Speedy Gonzales. Like, you know, watching that as a kid and people like, you know, as an adult, they're like, that's like super racist. You're like, yeah, it kind of is, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. But I mean, I don't begrudge them for making that. I mean, if somebody was like, hey, I'm making a new fucking Speedy Gonzales cartoon, then I'd be like, I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, treading on some
water. But if you watch an old Speedy Gonzales cartoon, you're like, this is a little racist.
I don't know. Like you said, history.
History.
But the thing that's weird about this, though, is like I said, like they're finding these mammoth bones, and the Europe's like, fuck your mammoth, ours are better. Like, we have that with like sports today. You know, like Olympics come around, like, oh, our athletes are better than your athletes because we spend tons of money into this amateur sport to make sure every 4 years we win more gold medals and then charge them taxes on their gold medals. Do you know that happens? It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Like, hey, congratulations, you just won a gold medal. It's going to be $6,000 in taxes.
Mm-hmm. And you're going to pay it because, fuck, like, you earn that shit.
The only other thing you do, I think, is sell it, and then you probably get double taxed.
Yeah.
Like I said, Richard, history.
No, that still happens.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
That's the present, see? 100 years from now, they're going to be like, you know, they made them pay taxes on those fucking
medals.
That's
what's going to be, yeah. Olympics 6032, and they're going to be like, did you know they used to pay taxes on this? Like, wait, what's
fucking
taxes?
Fucking savages.
What are governments? What's the Olympics? What are you talking? Why are you talking out of your mouth?
Well, use your brain to brain.
Use your B2B, dude. Come on. Stop living in 2027.
You made it sound dirty.
B2B.
B2B.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. That's okay. There's a scary thought.
Ass to ass.
If we get B2B, what happens if, like, somebody can, like, do you think it turns off or can I look, like, into your brain right now?
I don't know. Well, I mean, I'm sure the early iterations of you won't be able to turn it off.
But, like, I'd be like Xander in that episode where Buffy can read brains. And he's like, sex. Oh, God. Buffy. Oh, Buffy's hot. Oh, God. Oh, Xander, is that all you think about? No, I gotta go.
Okay. So here's my question. So Europe's like, we have fucking mammoths or mastodons and they're better. Like, what's the comparison here? Like, our mastodons are bigger and I mean, like, how does...
I don't know. Like, that's what's weird to think about. Just the idea that they're looking at, even if it's the bones, or, like, I kind of feel like they're looking at animals. They're like, oh, my God, you have these deers, but our deers are better. Oh, you have bears. Our bears are better. It's like...
Yeah.
I guess
yeah.
It's just kind of like that ownership of the land, which I don't know if we really associate with as much today. Like, you own your land.
Yeah, it's like Europe digs up a T-Rex and then we dig up a T-Rex and then we're like, I bet our T-Rex had a fucking huge dick.
Yeah.
Big dick. And that's how it killed animals. That's how it killed all the other dinosaurs. It smacked them in the head with this fucking enormous wang.
And you know why it was so angry? Look at these small arms. It couldn't reach the big dick. It had to fight.
Yeah, and then Europe's like, fuck you. Our T-Rex dick was so much bigger.
Yeah, you're making, like, you're arguing. It's kind of like sports. You're arguing over something that doesn't matter. No, my team's better. Okay.
Our mastodons are better than your mastodons.
Okay, great.
Sure.
What's that do for you? We have better mastodons. Are you going to put it on your flag? No.
Maybe.
Are we done here?
We did already.
But they said that there's a simpler reason for this, Richard, which I kind of mentioned earlier, is that at this time, extinction wasn't an idea. People didn't understand or even conceive that things would just completely die out.
Yeah, that's kind of fucked up when you think about it. The things you would think that everything like lives forever. Like there was no planet-wide fucking cataclysmic event that happened. Yeah, that's kind of like a nice world to live in.
That's what I was going to ask. I mean, at this point, like I was kind of mentioning earlier, like you had all this land to the west of the Mississippi that was uncharted. So
right.
The sky's the limit what could live there, right?
Oh, my God. It's like a fucking, like it's all unmapped and unexplored. Yeah. Like, you don't know what the fuck's there. Maybe there's a jungle. You don't know.
Sasquatch.
Maybe there's underground ruins.
Hey, we found
Maybe there's a race. Yeah, there's a race of fucking people that live under the ground. There's big monkey monsters.
There's
called
gold
Sasquatches.
Monsters. You fight a gold monster, you kill it, and you become rich. Rich beyond your
years. There's dragons.
Yeah, there could have been. Nobody knows.
Oh my God. See, now if I was Lewis and Clark, they'd be like, okay, we're gonna go find the Pacific Ocean. And you're like, boring.
You know what we're looking for? Dragons. Shut up, Richard. No, I'm saying dragons. I heard you talk to Jefferson. He said mastodons, but I know he meant dragons.
Yep. Yep. Look at those bones. Those aren't mastodon bones. Those are dragon bones.
You're walking through the woods. You're like, dragon. Nope, that's a blue jay. Dragon. Nope, that's a cardinal. Blue. Oh, dragon. Nope, that's a butterfly.
Tree. Tree. Tree.
That's the other thing, too. You get to name all this stuff. So you could probably, like, you'd be the dude naming the birds all dragons. Like, we're not naming this a dragon. It's a blue jay.
Is that why we have dragon fruit?
Maybe. The Richard of 1807.
Is that why we have Komodo dragons?
Well, that wouldn't have been through this. That would have been Adam from Adam and Eve.
Adam's like, look at this. It's a fucking dragon.
God's like, don't say fucking. You said fucking. Go to your room, Adam. Oh, damn it. You're not going to take another rib, are you?
You know what happened last time?
Yeah. I didn't want to say anything, God, but she's been eyeing that fruit. I'm not talking about my package. Yeah. She's talking to that Satan snake.
Tugging at my fig leaves, if you know what I'm saying.
No, they didn't wear fig leaves.
I think you do.
Because they weren't embarrassed by it until you ate the fruit.
That's right. They ate the fruit, and then they were like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
Nipples are weird.
Yeah. You put on a shirt, Eve. What about you, Adam? No, mine are okay.
I know, right?
Kind of weird.
How did that work?
I don't know.
I'm guessing that Adam just didn't take a full bite of the apple, so he's like, no, these are fine.
Ah, yeah, he ate the bottom half. That's what happened. She ate the top and bottom. He just ate the bottom half. Like we've been saying, Richard, history.
I know, right?
But
Eve didn't mind when he ate the bottom half, if you know what I'm saying. Hi-yo! Oh, God.
God wakes up from his naps like, what are those two doing? Oh, God, what's he doing? Blah, 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 blah.
That's how they're supposed to do it in France way later. That's not supposed to happen for a little while.
All right, guys, I'm going to treat you like the French, and now you have to retreat the fuck out of here. Oh, that's a joke that'll be funny in 2,000 years.
No, 6,000 years.
Oh, is that when Adam and Eve supposed to happen was 4,000 years before?
Yeah. Yeah. Because the Earth's only 6,000 years old, Sean.
That's what I hear.
And flat.
I don't think those go hand in hand, but they are two theories. Didn't say good theories, just said theories. So in the late 18th century, Richard, the idea of extinction was only kind of just becoming popularized by some thinkers. This was actually kind of pre-Darwin age. So, of course, you know, we talk a lot of these times, religion kind of had a big part in some of this stuff. So extinction was like a violation of religious ideas. You know, God would not let animals go extinct, right? And then also it says secular ideas, you know, the balance of nature would never be so significantly upset. And for Jefferson in particular, extinction was just an unusual theory. And here's a quote. It says, in fine, the bones exist, he wrote. Therefore, the animal has existed. The movements of nature are in a never-ending circle. So again, just kind of that idea. And I think a lot of it, like, I think it's easier for us to kind of understand extinction, one, because of science, but two, because the world has gotten a lot smaller. You know, at this point in time, like, you think about it, the world would have been huge.
Well, and also, like, we didn't, I think when you, when you're talking about something like extinction, then you have to be like, well, what would cause everything to die?
Yeah.
Like, then you got to start talking about, like, extinction-level events. Like I said, that's why I was saying earlier that, like, oh, that'd be a nice, like, happy world to live in. Because, you know, how would you mind living in a world where you didn't, like, have the thought, like, hey, you know, at any given point in time, a giant fucking rock from space could, like, fall and slam into the planet, and then we're all dead?
Yeah. Or we run out of resources, or, you know, some worldwide plague gets spread by airplanes and kills us all.
Yeah.
Or the sun explodes.
Or a bunch of volcanoes erupt and cause nuclear winter.
Yeah. I'm not going to lie. I was driving home last night, or Friday night, and the moon and the sun were like the moon was coming up right as the sun was setting, which I know happens a lot. But it was just at a good angle where the sun really was blasting off the moon. And I swore for a little bit, it looked like the moon was getting bigger and bigger. And I had, for just a very short amount of time, was like, this is how it ends. The moon's going to crash into the Earth.
The moon's going to moon's gonna fall in and crash into Earth, and then we're all dead.
Yeah. Like, that sucks. I don't like that thought.
Well, Thomas Jefferson didn't live in that world.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, because you think, like, the worst thing that they probably knew of would have been, like, the
plague. He was like, let's go across the Mississippi River, and we'll find a dinosaur. Rah, 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 rah.
I'm going to ride a mammoth. I'm going to ride a mammoth. I'm going to call him Martha. So Jefferson asked Lewis and Clark to look for mastodons and sent Clark on a bone-hunting trip. Maybe that's why I thought it was two ladies.
Maybe that's why they found Sacagawea. Hi-oh!
Oh.
Because she was a lady, and he was on a bone hunt.
Wouldn't she be
and
on a bone hunt?
He's like, hey, Sacagawea, are you on a bone hunt? Are you on a bone hunt, too?
She's like, no. It's like, I don't blame you. We're out looking for mastodons.
White people, right?
We're out here looking for mastodons. What's a mastodon? It's a big, giant, hairy elephant. Those don't exist. What do you know?
How did they know what a mastodon looked like?
I mean, I would assume.
Because all they have are bones. How are they going to go like, hey, go look for giant hairy elephants?
That's
how
a
do
good
they
point.
Know?
I mean,
how do they know
known,
what a mastodon looked like?
They would have known.
What if they just found anything and they were like, mastodon? It's like me walking around and find it, be like, dragon, found it.
Send it back. Is this a mastodon? Is this a mastodon? What gets me my bonus? That can be a mastodon. No, I know they would have known it was probably elephant-like because it has elephant features, and they would have had skulls of those.
That's true. If like let's say they had a skeleton. Plus, like, I mean, kudos to them for figuring out how to like arrange a skeleton.
Because well, it's not like stupid. You know,
well, I know they're not stupid, but I'm saying, like, okay, if I give you a big, giant fucking pile of bones of an animal that you've never seen before and, like, have no idea what the fuck it's supposed to look like, and then you assemble, and then I want you to assemble said bones into the structure it's supposed to be.
Yeah, but the difference is you wouldn't...
That takes some smarts.
The difference is you wouldn't have me do that. You'd have some dude that's been, like, looking at dead bones his whole life. And so you'd be able to be like, oh, this looks like a leg bone.
This is a rib bone.
A face bone. This looks like a penis bone. This looks like a tailbone.
Face bone? You mean a skull?
Richard, I don't know science, okay? I studied English. I didn't study any history, obviously.
Obviously.
But no, I don't know. Would they have found like the frozen ones at this point too? Because I know the frozen ones, you can see that they have hair.
I don't know. It's not like they had jackhammers and shit back then.
No, they just...
They're digging through rocks. They're using, like, pickaxes and shovels.
Yeah, they just had pickaxes.
That's all they're doing.
That's what they got to do. But yeah, I mean, you didn't care. Like, there wasn't, like, OSHA back then. So you just hire a bunch of, you know...
Go ahead and say it. Hire a bunch of what?
Irish people, hire a bunch probably. Of what? Probably be a lot of Irish people you hire, honestly.
Yeah.
Maybe... Was this the railroad time? No, this would have been... Just before the railroad time.
And they're like, please, sir, we just want a potato. And he's like, shut your face, bone.
Yeah, keep digging. And then they die and you just throw them off the side and you don't have to pay them. I said.
Yeah, but if you do, then their bones get mixed in with the bones you're trying to find. And then all of a sudden you've got a mastodon with a
that's
fucking.
That's how you get with minotaurs. So that's one of the reasons.
We're looking for minotaurs. So now they're looking for minotaurs and mastodons. I don't know if I want to go find mastodons. I want to find something cooler. Like if Thomas Jefferson was like, go find dragons, I'd be like, sold.
Yeah, but.
Or like, hey, I think there's a unicorn out there. I'd be like, oh, I got it.
Oh, Martha. No, not that kind of unicorn. Oh, damn.
Oh. Still keeping it.
Sacagawea? No, you're not into that either.
Damn it.
1807 sucked.
Exploring's hard.
I mean, literally, look at me. I got all excited. You said unicorns.
Day 5. This blows.
No mastodons. No unicorns.
No unicorns.
No dragons. And I have dysentery. Day 6. Still none of the above. And I'm still pooping. Day 7, I'm dead.
It's coming out of my face bone now.
Day 8, Lewis and Clark left me. Apparently, when you name 17 things dragons, they get testy.
People get all fucking buttered about it.
So that's one of the reasons he said they sent Lewis and Clark. So the official purpose, obviously, was to find new opportunities for commerce. Jefferson also wanted Lewis and Clark to collect samples of bones they found and search for any mysterious new animals, which I know along the way they did get to name a bunch of animals, which I don't know which ones they've specifically named.
Oh, they didn't put a list?
No, that there's sucks. No list of them there. And honestly, I would imagine Sacagawea would be like, we call it that. And like, all right, well, we'll go with that.
Yeah, sounds good.
We call that a beaver. Do you eat it?
What do you do with a beaver?
You can eat one and then wear it as a hat. You can shave the beaver.
Wear it as a hat?
How old are you guys?
Savages?
So Clark sent more than 300 bones back to the White House in 1808, and Jefferson arranged them in the storage area that would become the White House's East Room. So this is Jefferson spending his time as president arranging these bones. Like, hey, we've got some issues.
Oh, okay. I've got a list of things that Lewis and Clark discovered, okay? They discovered the black-tailed prairie dog.
Which those actually, I think, carry the plague.
They discovered the bushy-tailed wood rat. They discovered the mule deer.
Oh, yeah.
The pronghorn, the swift fox, the white-tailed jackrabbit, and they also discovered the grizzly bear, which I assume was a very bad day.
That one was probably not very fun. They were probably like, holy day shit, it's a fucking mastodon.
It's probably. Put the tusks next to it to see if it really is one. See if they match.
That's yeah, that's one of those things. It's like, it's coming at us. What do we do? Shoot it. Bang, 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 bang. Ah, yes, we. No. Shit, it's still coming. Load.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Quick, run. Wait, I got a bullet. Bang.
If only Frontier Leo was here.
Why'd you shoot me in the leg?
I don't have to outrun the, what are we calling it?
Don't worry, bear? Grizzly. We'll come back for your bow. Oh, grizzly bear. Perfect. We'll name it after you.
Yeah.
The guy that
it's like eating somebody. Grizzly. Like, oh, that's a grizzly scene.
Grizzly.
Hey, grizzly. Grizzly.
Bear. Nailed it. Let's see. So, like I said, Jefferson at this point, he's president. There's a lot of like other things he probably needs to worry about. Like, we got the War of 1812 coming up soon.
Right.
I'll tell you what, though,
just to end that, if I was Lewis and Clark, I would have named the grizzly bear a mastodon and just ran the fuck back home.
Oh, good point.
Right?
Hey, Jefferson. Because
you just be like, mastodon. Then you just come back and be like, oh, we found one, but it ate like four people.
We found it. It didn't want to be found. spoiler.
Can I ride it? I mean,
once.
Try.
It's got a good carrying in its mouth and belly.
There's a Russian dictator that's going to ride it in like 200 years.
Did he ride one? A grizzly? Or is that just a
There's picture? A picture of him on one.
Do they don't have grizzlies in... Do they have grizzlies in Russia?
Fuck if I don't know.
I think they have bears, but I don't think they have grizzlies. I think grizzly's just an American thing, isn't it?
I think so. I'm just saying, there's a picture of Putin riding a bear. With no shirt.
Well, you know what, Richard? There's a picture of George Washington on a raptor. Doesn't mean it's true.
And that's fucking boss. That's what that is.
And then one last
USA. USA. And he's on top of the raptor while building the fucking pyramids. Yeah, that's what he's doing.
But like I said, like at this point, there's a War of 1812 coming up. Like, so there's some British, you know, stuff going on. I think the North and South wasn't on the best terms ever. There was like some rumblings going on there. But Jefferson decides that his best use of time is to try and put together this mastodon bone stuff.
Okay.
Seems like a good idea, right?
Yeah, ish.
but I guess like this exercise wasn't too whimsical because French scientists were able to classify the American mastodon as a different species than the European mammoth. So basically mastodon. They said that these were two different. No, it says American mastodon and a European mammoth.
What's the difference between mastodons and mammoths? Cause I feel like I was interchanging the two in my head earlier.
I thought they were kind of the same thing too. Mastodon is a band.
Apparently.
From Georgia.
Dude, fucking Lewis and Clark discovered a bunch of shit. They got a whole list of shit they discovered on Wikipedia. Like, it's a giant fuck-off list. They found
they were the first to find oral sex. Well, that's weird. Well, it was a long trip, and they got bored.
Yeah.
And they had a French person with them.
Wait a minute. It just says they ate beaver. It doesn't say anything about discovering oral sex. Oh, I see what happened here. Common miscommunication. They discovered a bull snake. They discovered a blue catfish. They were the first to find white sturgeon.
I wonder what if they ate a lot of those things too. It's like, all right, eat this. Do you die?
Probably.
No. Okay. Whew.
Like, what's this? I don't know, but I'm fucking hungry. Will it cook? Fuck it.
We got oil. Let's boil it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the
I mean, that's
thing.
What I'm doing.
That's the other
like,
thing.
What are we eating right now? And then you're like, dragon.
dragon fish.
All dragon meat.
That's the other thing to think about. Like, at this point in time, too, you were literally just frying something over a fire and eating it. Like, there wasn't much seasonings. You know, you didn't really have a lot of good stuff. Like, now, you go to Walmart, you can buy all kinds of seasoning for, like, $12. Be set for life.
Well, they had salt.
Well, I mean, doesn't add too much flavor.
Salt and pepper can do the trick. I would submit that salt and pepper, I could season things with just salt and pepper.
You can.
And blow your mind.
But, I mean, I could go through, a bunch of different seasonings and throw in combinations that just make your mouth dance.
Oh, look at you.
I know, right?
Making my mouth dance.
Yeah. That's what Lewis was doing to Clark. It's like, Lewis, come here. My mouth is dancing. Aww. Don't tell Jefferson. So Jefferson.
I don't know about mammoths, but I've got a bone.
It's okay. We're not in the States. They won't judge us here.
Yeah. We're across the river. It's fine.
I heard that Franklin guy.
What's that? I don't know. Oh, my God. It's one of those grizzly bears.
Hey, guys. So Jefferson's interest in bones didn't only extend to finding the mastodon, though. So I guess he thought he was the first person to identify a new creature. He thought he found a lion in the Americans, Richard.
I mean, I could see it.
Yeah. But what it turned out to be, Richard, was just a giant ground sloth, which, A, I didn't even know there was ground sloths in America.
I didn't either. I don't see how you could confuse a fucking ground sloth for a lion, though.
Which I think it's just bones. So it feels like Jefferson's like spending his time looking over these bones and making determinations what
and
kind
just
of animal
fucking making shit up.
Yeah, because it says here his proudest discovery was the Megalonyx jeffersonii, which continues to have his name to this day. He found it in 1797.
Okay.
So he named the creature Megalonyx, which is Great Claw, and his name Jefferson, which was a lion-like creature that matched American ambitions. Oh, yeah. So it's basically like, I found this animal that lived in the Americans, and it has the spirit of America. It's fierce, it's gigantic, and it's untamable like the American spirit.
Yeah. Kind of like
Vince McMahon.
But not an asshole.
Yeah. Well, kind of an asshole. But it was actually just...
He's probably just fucking putting random bones together, and he's like, what's that look like to you? I don't know. I'm going to say hairy elephant.
Dragon.
Look at that face bone.
But this actually just turned out to be a ground sloth that was 9 feet long, Richard.
Holy shit.
Yeah, and this was one that was extinct. So like he's looking at it, he's like, holy shit, there's a fucking 9-foot sloth. But it was actually extinct. And it lived in the United States, Canada, and Mexico 150,000 to 10,000 years ago. So they need to put an edit point here because you said, Richard, the Earth is only 6,000 years old.
That's a good point. And flat.
Yeah. Like history. Like we
and
said.
Dinosaurs live underneath it, right?
Oh, God, I hope not.
Isn't that...
What would be scary to you? Something coming from above or below? Like, what if dinosaurs just all of a sudden, like, you talked about, like, mountains moving. Like, what happens, like, a mountain crumbles and, like, T-Rexes start coming out and velociraptors?
That'd be fucked up.
Yeah.
Because here's the thing is, like, okay, like, let's say, you know, aliens show up. Then, like, you kind of know where they're coming from. They're coming from outer space, right?
Yeah. And you're kind of like, oh, okay, I can see it. Like,
yeah, okay. Like, they're flying in on spaceships and blah, blah, blah. If you're talking about fucking shit coming up from under the ground, like all of a sudden like a T-Rex pops up in your fucking backyard, then you're sitting there going, what the fuck else is underneath my feet?
How fucking far does that rabbit hole go?
Right? Literally. How far does that T-Rex hole go?
You would feel like Lewis and Clark at that point. You'd be like, my whole world's turned upside down. I thought this world was small. It's fucking huge.
Maybe there are dragons.
And they're like, we've been down here the whole time.
Oh my God. And what if they learned how to talk?
The dinosaurs?
Yeah.
Like, hey, you guys stop flushing your shit down here.
It's so good to be out of there. Oh, my God.
Fresh air.
You guys suck.
All right. Let's start eating in Ohio. Why Ohio?
Because that's where the dragons lived. I knew it.
Let's see. So Jefferson wanted to disprove that this animal he found was extinct. So he kind of sent them to find that too. But basically they couldn't find anything with it, right? So around the same time, Jefferson's view of the world changed. By 1823, so this would have been after his presidency, he wrote to John Adams that he believed extinction was possible.
Okay.
And that animals could become extinct if they were replaced by new forms. So he's basically like saying, like, hey, if they Doctor Who this, then they could, then it's real.
Yeah, yeah. Although how shitty do you feel if you're Lewis and Clark? Like, you get back and then you're like, hey, we didn't find any mastodons, but we found a bunch of other stuff. And then he's like, I'm done with mastodons.
He's like, that grizzly bear was a mastodon. It just changed forms.
Yeah. What about the dragons? Then you're like, what? What do you mean changed form? That grizzly bear ate like half our people.
What's this Jefferson smoking? That's what I want to know.
There was this weird guy fucking up against a tree with a knife, and he talked like this all the time. And he said his name was Leo, and he's like, I'm going to go fight the grizzly bear. And you know what? He did fight the grizzly bear. You know what happened? It didn't turn out well for poor Leo on the Lewis and Clark frontier.
I'm going to say this right now. Jefferson's weird. Founding father, more like weird-ass uncle. But Richard, you know, even if Jefferson was wrong about extinction, you know, sending Lewis and Clark that far west to kind of try to find these things that he thought were extinct, you know, got a lot of bones, probably got them looking at a lot of things they necessarily wouldn't be looking at. So I don't know.
And then they eventually figured out that extinction was possible, and they're like, wait a minute, we could all die.
Yeah,
a giant rock could fall from the sky, you know, and we're all gonna fucking die.
I feel like that's actually taking a bite out of the apple, because at this point you're kind of naive to it. It's like, oh my god, we're God's chosen, we'll be here forever. And then you get a little science in you, you're like, no, mm-hmm. Guess what, fuckers are gonna die one day. That sun,
yep,
it's not gonna last forever.
Nope, it's gonna get like four times its size, and we're gonna get swallowed up in it.
Yeah. Hey, look at that moon. You see it? It's getting bigger, isn't it? You know why?
It's
crash
into us. It's gonna crash in.
It's coming right now. Stop sinning, you sons of bitches.
Yep. And then dinosaurs are gonna come out from under the ground.
So as we're tidying up this episode, I kind of want to, like, Earth ending. Like, what would you, if you've got to be there for it? Would it be sun explosion? Would it be volcano, moon crashing in, asteroid? Like,
well, the sun's not gonna explode. The sun's gonna like swell up.
Well, like,
and then we're gonna get swallowed up in it.
Isn't that what happens?
And well, it's gonna swell up, and then it's gonna burn for another few million years, and then it's gonna red giant, and then it's gonna.
But that, I say blow up. It's gonna basically fry our planet.
Yes. Yes, it's not only is it going to fry our planet, like, it's going, the sun is going to consume our planet.
But would that be like an instant?
Like, where
thing?
You and I are right now, in like so many billions of, in like a couple million years,
in like 6 weeks,
then where you and I are, it's going to be sun, like the sun.
But would it be instant, or would it be like, ah, man, it's hot? Oh God, it's hot. Oh,
no, it's going to be it's going to be like, hey, I'm getting hot. And then it's just going to keep coming and coming and coming until we're all dead.
So you're going to burn alive. Thanks, Richard. I don't like that thought.
Well, you're not going to. You're going to be long dead.
That's what they say. That's the other freaky thing. Like, what happens? Like, oh, shit, like, this is going to happen on Tuesday.
That's a good point.
Yeah. They tell you 6 billion years, but, you know, history, Richard.
6 billion, more like 6 billion weeks. And when I say billion, I don't mean billion. I mean 6 weeks.
You know, it's May. It's going to be June. We're all going to be dead. We're not going to see the end of, well, we'll see the end of Game of Thrones. But I'm sorry. You're not going to see.
Oh, my God. How much would that suck?
I've thought about that. Like, I've just got it. Well,
what if the world ends before Game of Thrones?
Well, this is coming out in the future. So ideally, I've gotten to see Avengers. But, like, that's like the next thing. It's like, oh God, I hope I can make it to that. And then it's, oh God, I hope I can make it to the end of, you know,
Game of Thrones. And then it's going to be, oh God, I hope I can make it to Star Wars.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, good point.
It's always something on the horizon, Sean.
That's what keeps us going.
Mm-hmm. That's what perpetuates the human race. Game of Thrones and Star Wars.
That's true. Well, all right, Richard, well, as we're tidying up, do you have any Richard's closing thoughts on this expedition podcast of history?
Science is weird. History's weird. And be cool if dragons are real.
I don't know. I've seen Rain of Fire.
Which, you know what? Those dragons, I would say, like, in terms of, like, a CG dragon.
Yeah, they were pretty good.
Pre-Game of Thrones. Dragons and Rain of Fire were badass.
You know,
they
those
looked
dragons,
cool.
They kind of pissed off, too. They're like, we're going to burn your whole field and eat it, but we're going to kind of leave you alone.
Yeah. I wasn't super sold on Rain of Fire, but the dragons in that movie were fucking awesome.
Yeah, I need to rewatch it. It's been a minute since I've seen that movie.
Agreed.
I might hold it.
So there you go. There's my closing thought. Go watch Rain of Fire. Matthew McConaughey, hello. Yeah. And Christian Bale.
Yep. I might hold that movie a little higher than it should be, or I could have it a little bit too low. It just kind of depends. You go watch it, be like, holy shit, this is the fucking Lewis and Clark of dragon movies. What's that mean? It fucking makes my mouth dance.
Right in my fucking face bone.
All right, well, let me do a little bit of housekeeping. Visit our website, we're languageofbros.com. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at languageofbro. Email us at eatthebeaver@languageofbros.com. Like us on Facebook, and remember, we are part of the Pod Bros Network.
The best podcast network for your face bone.
Yeah. All right, Richard. Is there anything else before I close her out?
No. Nope. We're done here.
All right. Well, that's all the bro chat for this show. I'm Sean.
And I'm Richard.
And I say, as we're on this expedition and we're starving and hungry, that we go ahead and eat the beaver.
Or else we die of dysentery.
Yeah. What if beavers give you dysentery?
I bet they do.
Yeah. Don't say that to your wife.
I was going to say, I'm married, so I'm sorry, over.